Bristol Community College Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 2.1, Problem 3. This is Problem 3 from Section 2.1. Solve the system of linear equations 6x plus 7y equals negative 2 and 7x minus 6y equals 26. So, what we have to do is, step one, multiply one or both equations times some value so that one of the variables has the same number in front, but with opposite signs. So, our options are very similar. For the x's, we could go with 42x and negative 42x and cancel the x's. Or for the y's, 42y and negative 42y would cancel the y's. You should get the same answer either way. Since the y's have opposite signs already, I'm going to choose to cancel the y's. But the x's should work just as well. So if I want to make the top equation have a 42y, everything has to get multiplied times 6. So the top equation, everything times 6. 6 times 6x is 36x. 6 times 7y is 42y. And 6 times negative 2 is negative 12. Now the bottom equation has a negative 6y. I'd like to make it a negative 42y. So everything will have to get multiplied times 7. So the bottom equation, everything will be times 7. 7 times 7x is 49x. 7 times negative 6y will be negative 42y. And then 7 times 26 should be 182, if I'm doing my math correctly. And now step one is done. One of the variables has the same number in front but with opposite signs. I have a 42y and a negative 42y. So we move on to step two. Step two is add the equations together to cancel one of the variables. So now 36x plus 49x is going to be 85x. Positive 42y and negative 42y will cancel. And then negative 12 and positive 182 is 170, positive 170. So that's step two, add the equations together to cancel one of the variables. And we did, we're left with 85x equals 170. Step three is solve for the remaining variable. So I can divide out that 85. X equals 170 divided by 85, and that will be 2. Again, you can do that on your calculator if you don't see the answer easily. 170 divided by 85 equals 2. So X is 2. So step 4 is take the answer from step 3 and plug it back into either of the original equations to solve for the other variable. And again, it shouldn't matter which one you pick. You should get the same answer either way. I will pick the top equation, no special reason. So the top equation is 6x plus 7y equals negative 2. And now that I know that x is 2, the 6x will become 6 times 2 plus 7y equals negative 2. 6 times 2 is 12. 12 plus 7y equals negative 2. Now I need to get rid of the 12 on the left, so I'm going to subtract 12 on the left side of my equation, and I will also subtract 12 on the right side of my equation. So on the left, the 12s cancel. I have 7y equals negative 2, and negative 12 will be negative 14. So now if I divide the 7, y equals negative 14 over 7. Y is negative 2. So x is positive 2. Y is negative 2. That's the solution to this system of linear equations. And if you did draw the graph, these two linear equations would intersect at the point 2 comma negative 2. Positive 2 for the x value and negative 2 for the y value.